Well, hello, welcome to today's lecture. We're going to continue. So last time we introduced statements, mathematical statements, and then we said that, hey, we're going to come up with some operators to combine those statements. Then eventually our goal is to analyze the truth and falsity of combined or compound statements. Let's begin. Operatives, statements, and truth tables. Well, let us begin by a definition. Our definition about mathematical statements. A mathematical statement is a statement, is a sentence which is true or false, but not both at the same time. A mathematical statement is a statement, is a sentence, which is either true or it's false, but not both. Well, suppose we have some mathematical statements. Our goal is to create a new statement and analyze its truth or falsity. So this is our goal, to create new statements. We call them compound statements using some operators. Well, as we talked before, our very first operator is negation. Not so negation. As the first operator, remember that the symbol that we use is a tilde, not, and remember we talked about some programming languages, they use factorial next to the statement and they say, hey, it's the negation of. So if you have a statement like P, you have not P, or we can denote it by not P or not P. If you open different discrete math book, discrete structure books, you might see different symbols mentioning that it's the negation of the statement. So we read it as not, not this statement. So we analyze the truth and falsity of a statement using these operators by a simple and compact form that we call a truth table. So let us start working for the negation using a truth table. So the truth table for the negation is constructed this way. First of all, here you have your statement, which is P. The original statement P, remember that. Any mathematical statement is either true, it's either true, or it is false. So you have two options for the for statement P. The statement is true or it's false. We know that it's not both at the same time. On the right hand side, on the right column, we're going to write down the negation of P, which is our new statement. The negation of P. Well, if P is true, its negation is false. So I'm going to use a different color. Red. So if P is true, its negation is false. But What if my original statement was false to begin with? If my original statement is false, it means that its opposite is going to be true. So it doesn't matter what symbol you're using. These are falsity, truthness of your negation statement. Our next operator is conjunction. Conjunction, which we read and. Okay, when it comes to conjunction, we need at least two statements. The conjunction between two statements, P, Q, is denoted by the wedge operator. We read it and. Statement P and statement Q. Remember that this statement is true if both P and Q are true. So by knowing this fact, we're going to construct its truth table. So how many statements do we have? We have two statements. The first statement can be true, it can be false. The second statement can be true, it also can be false. It means that we have four combinations of different true, false, true, and so on for these two statements. To construct the truth table, we're going to write down P, the first statement, then the second statement Q, with four combinations. We usually write them this way. We say that, hey, let us list all possible values for P combined by Q this way. True, 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 false. What if your P is false? False, true, false, false. Well, and our last column is the compound statement P and Q. So let me use this color to show that this is our last column. The combination of P, Q using conjunction or AND. We said that, hey, P and Q is true if and only if both P and Q are true statements. True and true, true. True and false, false. False and true, false. False and false is false. Again, we're using the truth table to help us write everything in nice and compact form. After conjunction, we talked about OR. We call it disjunction. Disjunction, OR. Well, again, we need at least two statements. P or Q. Upside down wedge, which is OR. And we learned that this guy is false if and only if both the statements are false. That's how we define it. The truth table is defined this way. Again, since we have two statements, the combination 2 to the second power is going to be 4. So our first column is for P, second column is for Q, and the last column is actually just the compound statement that we have P or Q. Same as what we did for conjunction. And we're going to just list the truth and falsity for each of these statements this order. True, 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 false, false, true, false, false. Well, true or true is true. True or false is true. False or true is true. False or false is false. So if you combine true, true using or, the outcome is true. If you combine true, false using or, the outcome is true. If you combine false or true, you get true as well. The combination of false, false using or gives you a false statement. Next operator is conditional, if then. Conditional operator, if then. This operator is defined this way: P then Q. P then Q. If P then Q, if you have your hypothesis, then you have your conclusion. How we define this operator? We define it this way. Its truth table is defined this way. These are basic definitions. There you go. So again, since you have two statements, we get four combinations. The first column P, the second column Q, and the last column is P, then Q. If P, then Q. Well, okay. If P is true, Q true. P true, Q false. P false, Q true. P false, Q false. Now we define this operator. We define it this way. True, then true. True, then true is true. True, then false is false. False, then true is true. False, then false is true. So that's how we define this new operator. So these are the basics of compound statements. Later on, we're going to have more operators in one compound statement, and our job, our goal, is to analyze the truth and falsity of those new statements. But for this, you need to memorize these tables and these operators. More examples, let me give you a quick definition. Definition of equivalence or equivalent statements. Well, we say that two statements are equivalent to each other if they have exactly the same truth values. Two statements are equivalent if they have exactly the same truth values. Very good. So, example says, show that P and Q is equivalent to Q and P. Q and P. What does it mean? It means that if I change the order, PQ, QP, they are equivalent to each other. Okay. Let us check the truth table. I have two statements. I get four combinations. I have P, then Q on the second column. So this is my P, this is my Q, then I have P and Q, and I'm going to add a new column for Q and P. Q and P. Well, so we know that we get four combinations, true, 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 false, false, true, false, false. Okay, we already memorized the truth table. We know that true and true is true, true and false is false, false and true. You can look at your operator, false and true. I'm just focusing on the operator that I have. Is false, false, and false is also false. Now, if I show that on the last column, I get the exact same truth values, it means that these two statements are equivalent to each other. Well, this column says Q and P. Q and P. True and true, of course it's true. False and true is false. That's how we define the truth table for and. True and false is false. False and false is also false. Are these truth values the same? Take a look at them. True, true, yes. False, false. False, false. False, false. Every one of them are equal to each other. So you quickly say that, hey, P and Q is equivalent to Q and P. If I change the order, it doesn't change the validity, truth, or falseness of this compound statement. So they are equivalent. You can use equality or you can use equivalent notation.
Professor, this one you just said is conditional, right?
This one, yes. This is a conditional statement. If, then, hypothesis, conclusion.
All right, just trying to make sure.
Sure. Another example for you. You are sure that not P is the same as P. Okay, perfect. Double negations. This is actually a law, and we're trying to prove this law. So since you have just one statement, you only get one true, one false. So key can be true, it can be false. Take a look at your inner statement. The inner statement is not P. So let us construct not P first. Then we move on to not P. So not P, number one, and then not P as the next statement. Next compound statement, number two. So this is going to be not P. Well, if P is true, not P is false. Okay, if not P, this inner statement is false, its negation is true. What if P is false? If P is false, not P is true. If not P is true, not true is false. Well, on the left hand side, you have all the values for P. P is true, not P is true as well. P is false, not P is false as well. So since all of the true values are the same, you say that, hey, these two are equal to each other, they're equivalent to each other, and you're right, not P, equivalent to P. It more interesting. This example says analyze the truth and falsity of this statement. Analyze the truth values of this statement given to you is not P and Q, and also not P and not Q, and also not P or not Q. Then decide which ones are equivalent to each other. So one by one, we try to construct the truth table for each of these, then we decide which ones are equivalent to each other. It means that which ones have the exact same truth values. So since we have two statements, P and Q, we have two squared or four combinations, or we have four rows from left. I start by writing P, then Q. Okay, I'm looking at this one. This is P and Q. Then it's negation. So this is my first, and this is my second step in constructing the truth table for not P and Q. So one, P and Q, and two gives me not P and Q. So let us finish the truth values for the first statement, first compound statement, then we move on to the next one. So true, true, false, false, true, false, true, false. We just memorized how to construct the truth table for and. True and true is true. True and false is false. This is our operator, conjunction, and. False and true is false. False and false is false again. Well, now I'm looking at the negation of this column. Not true is false. Not false is true. Not false is true. Not false is true. Well, I'm done with this statement. Now, let us move on to the next statement. For this statement, I'm going to follow, let me change the color of these numbers so you don't get confused. This is one, this is two. Now I'm going to just use red for this statement. Then I'm going to use green for the second statement. For this statement, I have not P. So I'm going to construct not P, then not Q. Then I need to construct the combination of both, which is using. So here we go. There you go. Not P. I already have the column for P. Not P, not true. So this is not P. Not true is false. Not true is false. Not false is true. Not false is true. True is not Q. Not true is false. Not false is true. Not false. Not true is false. And not false is true. Now tree says, hey, take not P, take not Q, combine them using conjunction and. So here we have not P and not Q. Well, I'm combining these two columns using and. Very well. False and false is false. False and true, false. True and false, false. True and true is true. So this is for this column. Separating these from each other. And finally, I have not P or not Q. I already have not P, I already have not Q. I just need to combine not P, not Q using OR. So let's just look at this as a block. So I'm just adding a column. Not P or not Q. Well, not P, not Q. Using or false is false. False or true, I'm using the operator or, false or true is true. True or false is true. True or true is true. Okay. So now let us investigate. Which ones are equivalent to each other? Okay, so you can forget about these columns because you're not using these. You're not using these anymore. You have three columns to compare. This column, which is not P and Q, this column, not P and not Q, and the last column, which is not P or not Q. Which ones are the same? Very well. Here you have false, false. Okay, so far so good. True, false. They are not the same. But look at these two. True, 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 true. It means that this column and the last column are the same. They are equivalent to each other. What are those? It says, hey, if you have a compound statement like not P and Q, you can replace it by not P or not Q. Not P or not Q. You can use equality or you can use equivalent symbol. They are all the same. We call this De Morgan's law. De Morgan's laws. The first one, which is proof, is if you distribute negation over and you get the negation of the first statement or the negation of the second statement. So we are distributing the negation over and distributing the negation over and the negation of P. The negation of and is or. This is the most important part. The negation of and is or, and finally we have to negate the last statement, not Q. Now I expect you to ask, what if I distribute negation over or? What is the negation of this statement, P or Q? What about this case? You have to follow the same thing. We distribute negation into the parentheses. So they have to negate the first statement. They have to negate the operator. They have to negate the last statement. This is not P and not Q. So you get not P, not the first statement, and not the second statement. You can put them in parentheses if you feel more comfortable, or you can leave them as they are. These are called De Morgan's laws. Perfect. Our next step, more definitions. Definition of tautology and contradiction. Then we're going to move to the definition of converse, inverse, contrapositive. Well, we say that the statement is a tautology if it's always true. A statement is called a tautology if it is always true. It means that if you form the truth table for that, the last column is always true. And the statement is called contradiction if it's always false. A statement is called contradiction if it is always false. Well, always true, always false. They have a name. We denote a tautology by T, and we denote a contradiction by C. More definitions for you. Let P and Q be two statements. We can form some new statements, and we have a specific name for them. We have converse, we have inverse, and we have contrapositive. So how do we define them? So we have two statements, P and Q. Recall that when you have P and Q, you can form a conditional statement like if you get above 92% in a class, your letter grade is going to be A. So P, then Q, we already defined this as a conditional statement. If you switch hypothesis and conclusion, you get something that we call a converse. So, Q, then P is your converse. What is inverse? Inverse is when you negate the hypothesis. Negate the conclusion and use a conditional relation between them. So not P, then not Q is called the inverse. What if you construct a conditional statement using the negation of these two statements by switching them? Not Q, then not P. This is called a contrapositive. Let us take a look at the truth table related to the converse, inverse, contrapositive, see which ones are equivalent to a conditional statement that we define originally. Okay. Since you have two statements, you get four combinations. PQ. I'm going to write the original down here. P then Q. Then I'm going to write the converse here. Q then P. This is your converse. Then I'm going to form the inverse for you. So I need not P. I also need not Q. And I need not P, then not Q. So let me write this with a different color. So this is your inverse. And finally, you have your contrapositive. Not Q, then not P. Okay, perfect. So again, four combinations. True, true. False, false. True, false. True, false. We already defined this as the operator forming a compound statement. True, then true is true. True, then false is false. False, then true is true. False, then false is true. Okay, take a look at this. It says Q, then P. Guys, the order is very important here. We have to be careful about the order. It says Q comes first, then you have your P. So we have to read it from right to left. True, then true is true. False, then true is true. True, then false is false. False, then false is true. So this is the truth values for your converse. Are they the same? Unfortunately not. As you can see, these two are not equal to each other. So let me separate these. This is for your converse. Now I'm going to form my inverse. What I need the negation of my hypothesis. I need the negation of my conclusion, not P. So here I have not P, which is false, then true, not Q. I have false, I have true, I have false, and I have true. Okay, now I'm going to construct the inverse. Not P, then not Q. Not P, then not Q. So false, then false. False, then false. It is true. False, then true. It is true. True, then false. Of course it's false. True, then true. It is true. Okay, let's take a look at this. Let me use a different color for this one as well. So you have your conditional statements. They are true. Here we stop. False and true are not the same. So it's not equivalent to P then Q. So far, you know that they are not equivalent. What about the contrapositive? Again, guys, be careful. When you're constructing contrapositive, not Q comes first. Not Q, then not P. Not Q comes first. So we read it from right to left. False, then false is true. False, then false is true. True, then false is false. True, then false is false. False, then true is true. And finally, true, then true is true. Take a look at these two columns. The last column and your conditional column. True, true, they are the same. False, false, they are the same. True, they are the same. True, they are the same. So the only statement equivalent to conditional statement is contrapositive. Important. What is important? It's important that P then Q is equivalent to, it's the same as contrapositive, not Q, then not P. There we go. Let us finish this off. One important relation between conditional statement and the operator or. So we're going to show that P, then Q is equivalent to not P or Q. One important relation that shows connection between a conditional statement and an operator, which in this case is or. Note that we have to negate the hypothesis, then use or. We prove this using the truth table. Okay, so since we have two statements, we get four combinations. We have P, we have Q, we know that P then Q. Okay, so I'm going to separate these. And then I have not P or Q. So I need not P on the right-hand side. So this is my right-hand side. I need not P, so I'm going to construct not P, and then I have my Q, and just combine them together. Not P or Q. So this is my second part. Okay, perfect. Q, true, false, false, true, false, true, false. True, then true. Again, guys, when it comes to conditional statement, order is very important. True, then true is true. True, then false, it is false. False, then true, lower than maybe 2%, but get A in the class. Yes, of course, this is true. False, then false, didn't get 92%, didn't receive letter grade A, of course it's true. Okay, now let's move on to the next part, not P. So what I need the negation of P, which is false, false, true, true. Then I'm combining not P, Q, using or. Remember or, A or B was like this. It had A, it had B, these are just statements. And we already memorized this. True, true, false, false, true, false, true, false, true, 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 false. Okay. True or false, true. False or false is false. True or true, true. True or false, true. What I'm trying to do, I'm trying to see if my conditional statement is the same as not P or Q. It means that their truth values must be the same. True, true. Yes, of course, they are the same. False, false. They are the same. True, true. Yes. And finally, true, true. They are equivalent. P then Q is the same as not P or Q. This is another important relation that you have to know. So let me write it here. Important, P then Q is equivalent to not P or Q. These are just statements, A and B, These are just statements. Instead of P, Q, R, you can use A, B, C. You can use anything that you like. One last definition. Definition of a conditional statement. What? A and B, P and Q, A and B, or P and Q, be two statements. We can form a new statement that we call a biconditional statement. A new compound statement, which we call a biconditional statement, and we denote this P if and only if Q. So if P then Q, if Q then P, and we call it a biconditional statement. This statement is true if and only if both P and Q have the same truth values. Okay, so now the truth table is going to be easy for us. P, Q, P, if and only if Q. True, true, false, false, true, false, true, false. True, if and only if true, do we have the same, exact same value? Yes, so it's going to be true. True, if and only if false, it's false, because these two values are different from each other. False, if and only if true, they have different values, so it's going to be false. False, if and only if false. False implies false. False implies false. Do they have the exact same value? Yes, so this is true. Now I expect you to ask this question. Hey, professor, you introduced a lot of operators for us, but if we have a compound statement including a lot of operators, which one comes first? Is it the negation, and, or, implication, biconditional, which one comes first? So the priority for operators are like this. First, if you see negation, you have to deal with the negation. So the first one is negation. Negation takes the priority. Then after you're done with the negation, you have to look for and or. And if you have, for example, a statement like this, P and Q or R, which one comes first? Is this and? Is this or? If you read it from left to right, right to left, this statement is not true. When you see a statement like this, it's not true. It must be written P and Q or R, or it must be written as P and Q or you must have parentheses. Otherwise, we don't know which one comes first. It's not reading from left to right. It's not that. It's not working like algebra. It's logic. It's different. You have to have parentheses involved. And three, if you have conditional, if you have biconditional, conditional, biconditional. Again, if you see a statement like this, P then Q, if and only if R, you stop, you say it doesn't make sense. You have to have parentheses involved. You have to have, for example, P then Q, if and only if R, or you need to see P then Q, if and only if R. Either this or